First of all, congratulations not only on being accepted at the festival with Rabbit, your short film, but also you just picked up a major award for a film that does not exist yet. It exists on paper, and that's what you were working on at the lab. So it's like all this love is
it's crazy.
They're throwing you all this love. The award that you received actually went to Beast of the Southern Wild a couple of years ago, just to give you a perspective of
I'm sorry,
but you are in the biz, so you're very familiar with all this stuff, so congratulations
thank you very much.
Rabbit sort of feels like an exploratory exercise as to what Mustang could eventually be. Am I right or am I wrong?
Yeah, completely. You're right.
But it's just different animals?
Yes, it's okay. The only thing changing. And also, Rabbit takes place in a female prison.
Okay.
And actually, Mustang will be in a male prison.
Okay. And in terms of your... How did Rabbit come to you, or how did you find Rabbit? Was it... I mean, because it touches upon... you know, this is real life. The people do rehabilitate themselves through various programs like this, and they exist all over the world. How did you meet this project? How did it fall in your lap?
I read an article a few years ago about animal therapy.
Okay.
In the French paper.
Yeah.
It was about a therapist. She was bringing small animals in this prison in France, in Strasbourg.
Okay.
I got very, very surprised and stunned. And actually, I first thought it was a comedy subject. I was like, wow, rabbits, mouses, birds in a prison. It sounds very over that. I want to see that. So I called this therapist. I followed her one day in this prison.
Okay.
And what I saw was magical.
Okay.
Those inmates were connecting, opening themselves. To the animals, they completely forgot that we were around. So there was like this, we could assist and observe this unique pairing that they actually were exploring with these animals.
Mm-hmm.
And I really liked how she would pair each inmate
with a specific animal.
Yes, sort of.
Okay. So
yeah.
one lady.
One would have like the bird, the other one would have the rabbit, the other one the chinchilla, with this big guy with a small chinchilla petting I have like so many images in my head, and I was just really, really moved by what I saw. So I kept researching, and then I found out they had the same program in the States with wild horses.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, wow, that's
I think it's the subject of the film Buck, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, completely. Yeah, okay. It's not in prison. Buck is a documentary about horsemanship.
Yeah.
Based on the method of that man. Buck.
Okay.
But
it's a different strand.
It's based on the same. I mean, it's horsemanship. It's how to connect with an animal and a wild animal. Except that my subject happens in prison. So this and we rehabilitate people who deals with anger, with violence, with any sort of crimes, and it helps them to reconnect with their inner humanity and emotions. So when I actually, for my research, had to be doing this prison in Nevada, in Carson City, and I met these inmates and I could interview them, and they all said that they had the self-awareness of their crime and what they did, what triggers them to act that way. And connecting with the animal, having all this process of being not in control, but having being able to saddle them, to go on their back, and also to, you know, to have like this relationship with them, was self a huge self accomplishment that they never had outside of the prison. So it was kind of educational for them to follow this program, and it was very moving. It was very, very strong.
You have a really big filmography. You've been in film for a little while. I mean, Diving Bell, the short feature with Stella.
Rabbit. Yeah. It's Stella.
Brady Corbet
in the first one.
In the first film, and Stella's in this film. When is it showing, actually, in San Antonio?
Tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Yes, the first screening.
Well, that's going to be fine. So how does all your previous experience in film, in front of the camera, behind the camera, producing capacity, stuff like that, how does that inform this undertaking of this project on paper? How did all that previous baggage inform this?
Actually, I come from acting, and mm-hmm. I was acting since I was a kid, like 5 years old.
Yeah, you could.
Always around movie set. I had the chance to be on movie set mm-hmm. where I met directors, fantastic directors, like Luc Besson, Julien Schnabel, Raoul Ruiz. They would all work very, very differently, but I really, really liked to observe them. And I think inside I was like, oh, I'd like to do that. I was very excited about how they could make their conception real and impose their universe. So I was very fascinated about that. But I loved acting. I was really happy being part of that universe mm-hmm. and not necessarily controlled the mm-hmm. universe. Mm-hmm. And then suddenly I was in an acting school. I directed a play, Independence, which is an American play written by Lee Blessing.
Okay.
I loved that. I loved working with actors, directing them, and comes from that experience, I started to write short films, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna try, even if I'd never been in film school. I just wanted to try to see how. I spent a lot of time in New York, and it was also a good excuse to spend more time in New York.
Yeah.
And like a series of really good encounters was that girl who is in Atlantic Avenue, a good friend of mine, Leopoldine. She's uh-huh. handicapped. She said one day, oh, I want to do something about my handicap, maybe a documentary. And I was like, no, let's do a short film. And then everything were pretty clear to me that I wanted to do something with her. Then Brady, by coincidence, bumped into us. It was like, oh, I'd like to do also this project. It was like, oh, perfect. So I wrote for them, and Brady helped me so much to also reshape my writing, as uh-huh. he always do. Uh-huh. He's like really like the best partner for all the process of writing. It really helped me to connect myself with the best people, with like the musicians Sander Jurians and Danny Benson.
Yeah, they
work
they,
with me on my
yeah,
post shorts
and
will work with me on the future. And so Brady was like kind of the key for me to open myself in that new world, which uh-huh. happened actually in New York.
Uh-huh.
So from Atlantic, then Rabbit, that actually I wrote with Brady and Mona,
yeah.
and Mustang, that we actually also wrote together. The
great,
first
great.
So yes, I mean, I once you're really well surrounded and you have the confidence to launch yourself into something, that I actually feel much more connected now to directing than acting, even if I love acting. But I mean, for me, it seems more complete, and I am extremely excited to be able eventually to do that feature. It was kind of a natural path that actually all these experiences helped me to do now what I want to do and to define myself as a new upcoming director, yeah. you know, like a young future director. So I think life is very well written
yeah.
in a way, you know, like everything really was necessary and useful.
How did the lab process help you in figuring out what the next steps are for your screenplay?
It was the best week, as we spent like actually the last week. I had a chance to meet like very strong advisors mm-hmm. with very different universe, and they all helped me to build up the spine of the film, of the mm-hmm. story. The first draft is there's a lot of things in it, which I think it's good. I just have to simplify now for the further draft, and they really helped me to, you know, to lead me in the right path.
Yeah.
Michel Sato, Paul Frederbusch, Matthew Taketa, all the staff, all the collaborators of the Sundance Institute have been extremely kind and generous and helpful, and it's the best support. I'm very, very happy to be part of this. It's cheesy to say that, but this community, because it's really a community.
Oh, it is,
and then
it
when
is,
you
it
feel
is.
Like supported like that mm-hmm. and encouraged, yeah, there's something that somehow you get the trust to say, ah, oh, yeah, I may direct my first feature. Maybe it's a possibility. So it feels really.
Yeah, it's going to happen. Actually, I have one extra last question, because what I find with the French people, France loves short films. There's a lot, like this
yeah.
short film will be seen Was it Studio Canal? What's the company that's gonna be? Charles
Gilibert.
Yeah, where is it gonna be shown? Where's the short? Where's Rabbit gonna be shown? Is it they?
It was released on Canal Plus.
Okay, oh, Canal Plus. Sorry,
Canal Plus. Studio Canal. No, he has been bought by Canal Plus.
Okay.
Pre-bought. So okay. The finance actually.
But that's great. See, that doesn't really happen anywhere else. No, that France is really proactive when it comes to short films.
Completely. They bought Atlantic Avenue and they actually trust us on Rabbit, so they were our partner. Then Ile de France was also a support, and Ministry of Culture. So yes, all this support from the government, actually.
For short film, too.
And for short film.
Thank you so much for your time. Enjoy your premiere tomorrow morning.
Thank you very much.
And enjoy the festival, and I really look forward to seeing not only the short, hopefully I'll be able to see it shortly, but following where you go with this project,
Mustang.
So merci.